sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. He's just one of those guys that if the game's on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we've got two teams who come in with identical records on the season. It's the Packers going up against the Panthers.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault, and that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Green Bay Packers. From around the league as our first one comes from New Orleans. The Jets out to the early lead. Josh McCown leading the way offensively. They go play action with Stewart. Now Newton. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. So here we go, back to the action. Football in the red zone. And a big third down play coming up for this defense. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Newton on third down. To the sideline, and oh, that's well done. Able to drag the feet, he's going to have the first down. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And it's incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
And on second and 10 now. Back to the ground now with Stewart, able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing on third down, Newton. It's caught right side, Dixon. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
And Gano's kick is right through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. A red zone situation coming up. We'll see how this defense can respond to an impending first and goal. With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. From the gun, here's Newton. And that'll be incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
On second down, they run with Stewart. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop. Ball right around the five here brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running.
And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Nick Perry in there to sack him. And that is 10 for him now on the year.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. Third and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack, and now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
On the NFL scoreboard, second. A red zone situation forthcoming as this defense will need to step up here. First and 10, ball at the 19. Stewart on first down. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Another run for Stewart. He's been busy. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll bring up a third down.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, it looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. And out of bounds, just shy of the end zone at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Great footwork there, Charles, to dot the I, stay in bounds, get both feet in. He's probably thinking, though, man, I made a catch like that close to the end zone, I should have scored.
Yeah, there's always a regret when you're that close to the goal line. But let's go back to what you talked about before, getting his feet down. Would you say dotting the I? Mm-hmm. I can cross the T as well. That was excellent footwork to get in bounds and make a great catch.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defensive front there. They held their ground, pretty much stoned him on that play and ended up creating a lost yardage play.
Yeah, drop him from the one back to the two. Try to punch it in, Stewart. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet, or they just exited.
Time for this defense to try and stiffen as they'll try here to defend a first and 10 situation at their own 17-yard line. Now a first down throw for Newton. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And that'll bring up second down.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for three and not giving up six.
And that's going to be incomplete. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And now it's third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Devin Funchess, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
This offense has struggled. They have not scored yet. They trail, but a chance here late in the second quarter to try to get some points on the board. We remind you that coming up later tonight, oh, this is going to be a good one. The Cowboys and the Raiders going at it in the East Bay.
Oh, that's old school right there.
Old school indeed. Then Monday night, another good late season matchup. The Falcons and the Buccaneers from Tampa to wrap up week 15. They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Now it's Rodgers, caught on the right side by Adams. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it second and 14. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Down, Rodgers. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. And Rodgers has it over on the right side. And eventually stopped just shy of the goal line right around the two. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving.
False start, offense.
And that'll set him back five.
Still first down.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Steps away to his left. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Get it!
Final shot before half for Rodgers. Now he's into the clear. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
All right, Brandon, we'll see if I can get through this without being skipped as we welcome you to our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Panthers are happy to be in front right now and just want to play two more solid quarters. The Packers didn't play their best, and they'll need to be at their best now to come back. All right, here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Panthers with the ball midway through the second. Stewart's looking for room to run, and this five-play drive goes for a touchdown. That takes the lead up to 12. Now to late in the second. Cam Newton looking for his big receiver, Devin Funchess. And this goes 17 yards for the score. Panthers up now by 19. Still a little time left on the clock. Here the throw is hurried and picked off. Davis in position, and he's the one who comes away with the ball.
Time to jump back in. Opening drive, third quarter. And this offense has it in the red zone, first and 10. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Now, I can't imagine any celebrations being any bigger than your first NFL touchdown. And this rookie running back is still seeking his. He's not going to get it on that play.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Thomas Davis leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6.
Look, Carolina had a number of issues last year, and that's why they slumped to 6-10 after a Super Bowl appearance. But pass rush wasn't a problem for them. They still got to the quarterback.
47 total sacks. That was just one behind Arizona, who led the league.
Yeah, I think the biggest issue for them, young corners, they gave up a lot of big plays.
And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage.
Checking things elsewhere. Third quarter now from U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Andy Dalton with one touchdown pass thus far. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's going to look deep down the field. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Rodgers gonna go on fourth down. And that is going to be incomplete. Mike McCarthy took the gamble, didn't pay. It's a third down situation in the fourth quarter. Time to see if this defense is up to the task. On third down, they go Montgomery. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Rodgers, gotta have this one. He's got Adams on the hookup, and he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. This offense has been sustaining a nice, long, successful drive here. Now they're looking to finish it off. First and goal in the red zone. Rodgers to throw once more. Eluding the pressure right. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. Aaron Rodgers taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Packers get a score closer. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And the Bengals, they have taken the lead there late in that ball game. Andy Dalton, a couple of touchdown passes thus far. Shipped together here from the D-line. On second down, here's Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Out of the gun, Newton. And this is going to be incomplete.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to, and maybe his rhythm is just off? He's got thrown off. He's going to have to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. He's at the 30, 20. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. So they fought half the battle here, but they're still down.
Plenty of work still left for them, but they delivered on the first step in their comeback attempt.
Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And the Vikings have scored, swinging back in front. Case Keenum, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is fielded at the 7. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Rodgers now on first down. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. They'll look to throw. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Back to throw. It's caught. Nelson. The old connection, Rodgers to Nelson, getting Green Bay a first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Back to throw. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
He's back to throw, and over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Open man, the tight end, Rodgers. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. It's a gain of 5 on the play. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Rodgers to throw. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed it. Instead, second down. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Kaywon Short in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. To throw is Rodgers. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Here's Rodgers. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. They had to go for it. Charles, we saw a comeback bid fall just a little short, but give them credit. They were able to hold on, withstand that comeback, and ultimately win it by the slim margin.
And bottom line, when it's all said and done, they don't ask you how much you won by. They just want to know, did you win? And that they did.
So for Carolina, the final 2 weeks are going to tell the story for them as they move to 9-5 with a win. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers come to town. Meanwhile, for the Packers, they fall to 8-6 with the loss. And they'll get a home date next week against the Minnesota Vikings. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.